traditional solid black trunks and fighting out of Catskill, New York. He weighed in at a ready 219 pounds with an outstanding record of 44 wins, only one defeat. He has 38 big wins coming by way of knockout. He is the youngest man ever to win the heavyweight title and the last unified in the ring by beating the champions of the WBC, WBA, and IBF. Tonight's challenger is the current WBC heavyweight champion of the world. Please welcome the former undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, introducing the one and only Iron Mike Tyson. And his opponent across the ring is the champion defending his title tonight, hiding out of the red corner, entering the ring wearing white trunks with blue and red trim, fighting out of and representing his hometown of Atlantic City, New Jersey. He weighed in at a ready 229 pounds with a record of 33 wins, 3 losses. He has 29 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight he is making the second defense of his title. Please welcome the current WBA heavyweight champion of the world. He is known as the Atlantic City Express. Introducing Bruce Seldon.
Richard Steele set to bring them together. Here we go, round one, scheduled for 12.
Bruce has used that jab, but already got hit with a hook. He's got to step to it once in a while.
We met at Baltimore School of the Arts. It was the first day, and he came over to me and introduced himself. And in high school, Paco was a little funny looking. Definitely, from looking at him, wasn't necessarily like the type of cat that I would even like deal with, you know. But as soon as he approached me, he was like a magnet. It was like once you paid attention to him, he kind of sucked you in. And we hit it off from that moment on. He would tell me all the time, Jada, you're going to be a star. You know what I mean? I'm like, Pa, come on. He's like, you're going to be a star. You got it. You just got it. I don't think either one of us really thought that we would have made it in the way that we did. But we knew we were going to do something. He was one of my best friends. He was like a brother. And sorry. He was I mean, it was beyond friendship for us, you know, as far as just, it was really difficult to explain because the type of relationship we had, you only get that once in a lifetime, so he was like a brother, father figure to me, very protective and we took really good care of each other. We took really good care of each other, the best that we could. But we gave each other a lot.
out of time, I just miss him. Just miss being able to holler at him like, dude, you know, I'm going through this problem and shit. You know what I'm saying?
It's like you're happy about having successful records with Tupac, producing him and all that, but at the same time, it's like he's not here to enjoy what you're enjoying, you know, while I'm alive.
And however it went down with them taking him away, he's still not gone. And still is going to be here for a long time to come. And even if music still wasn't coming from all the albums that's out now, we got enough to hold us over for centuries.
Pac showed me just be yourself and be true to everything you believe in, and it'll come. Don't come on this album, it'll come on the next album.
You know, no matter how bad it may get, just keep going, because you only fail when you give up.
He gave me pride. You know, he gave me love. He gave me inspiration. I don't think he realized how great he was. You know, I don't think he fully realized how much people admired him, you know, and thought of him.